noise until Monday morning rain. 15 cards and 15 restless riders, three conductors and 25 sets of me. All along the southbound Odyssey, the train rolled down again. Dreams have no rain. Big church full of old black men in the graveyard of the rusted old queen. Good morning, America. How are you? I said, don't you know me? I'm your native son. I'm the train.
Très bien ensemble. I can hear a heartbeat from a thousand miles in the heavens open every time she smiles. I come running to her, that's where I belong. I come running to her like a river song. Yes, she give me love, love, love.
Give me love. And if you ever change your mind about leaving me behind, oh, bring it, bring your sweet love, bring it over me, yeah, yeah. I know I'll let until I'm buried, yeah, I'm buried in my grave.
Sitting in the morning, watching the ships roll in. Yeah, I'm watching roll away. I'm just gonna sit at the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Ooh, sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. Will I let my boat in Georgia? I was sailing for the Frisco Bay. Now I have nothing left for. Looks like nothing's gonna come my way. I'm gonna sit at the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll in. Thank you.
Díiv galair agus fáilte go tús. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. You're all very welcome to the Technological University of the Shannon Conferring Ceremony. My name is Terry Toomey, and I'll be your Master of Ceremonies for today. A couple of housekeeping items before we begin. The emergency exits from the auditorium are through the glass doors marked with the green exit signs. Before we begin the formal proceedings, may I remind you to please switch off all mobile phones. The formal proceedings today commence with the academic procession. I now invite all present to please stand for the academic procession. Please be seated. I will begin by introducing the members of the conferring panel to you. To my left is Dr. Maria Kine, Dean of the Faculty of Engineering and the Built Environment. Next is Professor Vincent Canaan, President of the Technological University of the Shannon. Next is Ms. Josephine Feely, Chair of the Governing Body of TUS. And finally, Dr. Carl Glynn, Assistant Registrar of TUS. I now call on the Chair of the Governing Body, Ms. Josephine Feely, to deliver the graduation address.
Thank you, Dr. Toomey. Gar Margaret. Queenie Ushla. Is more on honor dumsa, falcha karoiv in you, quig an shermanish brunta kema, to quid ulskol technoliak den ishanina. Kun shipsha, round govila fusado, a ahench isikelura. Co gorgeous live galair. Ak nach even a solus nagrania ekol tevama. Isn't it wonderful to see the sun outside? It came out specially for you. And you're really welcome. Here this afternoon to you, the class of 2022. Today we recognize you, we celebrate you, and congratulations to all of you. Standing here today, I'm very conscious that during your time in college, you faced unprecedented challenges and that your student life was disrupted in all sorts of ways by the pandemic. But you met those challenges, and this deserves special recognition. Your journey through college reminds me of the words of Martin Luther King when he said, intelligence plus character, that is the goal of true education. So today in this ceremony, we recognize your singular achievement. The character you have shown, the knowledge you have acquired, will help to propel you, not just in your careers, but in your lives. You've shown the qualities to meet the challenges of the world, and I hope in turn, we have helped you to gain the wisdom to use your talents well. You're graduating at a time when the world is a very uncertain place, with a land war in Europe, an energy crisis, significant inflation, and a pandemic that just doesn't seem to want to go away. But it is also unmistakable that you're graduating at a time where there is a strong Irish labour market and where there is real and consistent demand for talent, for people with your qualifications, with the focus, resilience, and agility you have shown. And that is very good news for you, and long may it continue. In Thus, we believe in providing an education that makes people ready for life and for the workplace. And we also believe that this education should be available to as many people as possible. It's at the very heart of what we do, and we believe that by removing barriers to education, we will create a virtuous cycle throughout our region and beyond. And it was that disposition which led us to build on the work done in our founding institutes of technology to shortly become the first technological university to be designated a university of sanctuary, welcoming refugees, asylum seekers, and migrants who might otherwise encounter difficulties in accessing higher education. We're very well placed in Thus to do this as a diverse university with staff and students from about 100 countries on our campuses, and an ethic of openness and support which pervades our work. Nobody makes it through college without support, particularly in the circumstances you have experienced. And I would like to say a special word of thanks to the staff of Thus. Right across all the university functions, from the people who open the doors in the morning to the president who never seems to go home. They not only formed this technological university against the backdrop of a pandemic, but they made incredible efforts to keep our campuses and to keep you, our students, safe, and to maintain the delivery of your education in uncertain and daunting circumstances. And so too to your family and friends who are joining us today, I would like to acknowledge the central role that you have played in supporting the graduates on their journey through college to get to this stage. This is a proud moment for you as well, and I hope you all enjoy it. Graduands, today marks an end for you, but also a new beginning. Everybody here is proud of you and proud of what you've done. You should be proud of yourselves, and I hope you're also proud of the university of which you are now an alumnus. Congratulations once more. Even if your studies have finished for now, I encourage you to keep learning. For me, every day is a school day, and I hope it will be the same for you as you journey through life. There is an Irish saying, "Fáin cosar siúil rud nach fáin cos ina cónaí," which translates as a walking foot finds something that a resting foot wouldn't. But in a nutshell, it's about succeeding by lifting your foot and starting a journey. So I encourage you all to lift your feet, and I wish you every success in the next phase of life's journey, wherever that may take you. Cogorgis arish garan go vila fesado, bacorgi eva an brodulir fad, conigia folum gachlo, agasquiam gachra oriv, as shamak, kibebo her arano ishiv. Garamila Mahagrev is Canary Liv Gulair.
I now call on the President to formally confer the academic awards on the graduates.
Marchionne the Allscall Technolia Gnashona, Larira Iherlar, Brunum Dakna Tani, or Hoglamori, the Hallscall Technolia, a Tataration Cagden Shinna Wanchamak. Oxirum go Corfer, the Hoglamori Shinna Malahar, Conabara Hoverdov, go Formul. On behalf of the Technological University of the Shannon, Midlands Midwest, I hereby confer awards on the learners of the university who have achieved the standard for those awards. And I ask that those learners be presented to me so that I may formally present them with their parchment.
I now call on the Dean of Faculty, Dr. Maria Kine, to present the conferees for award.
Good afternoon, everybody. You are welcome to this graduation ceremony this afternoon for the three departments of the Faculty of Engineering and the Built Environment. The graduation ceremony today recognises your achievement in attaining a level of education reflected in the awards that you are about to receive. And I offer you all my heartiest congratulations. Today is a recognition of your achievements, what you have worked for, and you have earned the right to be here. Well done to you all, and you should be proud of your success. I would especially like to congratulate the first graduate from the MSc in Process Validation and Regulatory Affairs programme, which is a master's offered in collaboration with our industry partners, as well as the first graduates from the BSc in Aircraft Maintenance Engineering programme, delivered in collaboration with Atlantic Aviation Group. I now call on the President of the Technological University of the Shannon Midlands Midwest, Professor Vincent Canaan, to present the parchments to graduates of the Department of Electrical and Electronic Engineering, and request Mr. Keith Maloney, Department of Electrical and Electronic Engineering, to announce the graduates.
President, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed courses in the Faculty of Engineering in the Built Environment, Department of Electrical and Electronic Engineering, and are worthy of their awards. I request you present them with their parchments. Bachelor of Engineering and Electronic Engineering, Jack Dooley. Sampath Gayam. Simon Gabres. Erlandis Petkovitz. Bachelor of Engineering Honours in Electronic Engineering, John Coffey. Dara George. Matt Guillermo. Sean Lillis. Kieran Mallory. Rory McNamara. Rowan Tracy. Sam Wallace. Sebastian Wallenin. Bachelor of Engineering in Industrial Automation and Robotic Systems, Keane Cusick. Sean Devaney. No, not here. In absentia. Owen Hurley. Patrick Mays. Killian Thorpey. No. Yeah. Owen Thickbroom. Jessica Winters. Bachelor of Engineering Honours in Industrial Automation and Robotic Systems, Joseph Blackwell. Sam Costello. Paul Glynn. Jack Manley. Jane McCarthy. Bachelor of Engineering in Electrical Engineering, Kieran Clavin. Adam Duggan. Marius Palak. Bachelor of Engineering Honours in Electrical Engineering, Richard Boland. Phelan Begley. Graham Burke. Keane Fitzgibbon. Connor Hayden. Ross McNamara. Paula Haney. David O'Toole. Michael Ryan. Bachelor of Engineering in Renewable and Electrical Energy Engineering, Leo Costigan. Neil Doherty. Frank Haverty. Bachelor of Engineering Honours in Renewable and Electrical Energy Engineering, Yara Balsiabi. Niall Fadden. Amna Moylish. Aideen O'Hagan. Jamie Quinn. Luke Short. Bachelor of Engineering in Industrial Electrical Engineering, Noel Brady. Colin Brennan. Horry Carty. Michael Grace. Kevin Houghton. Simon Kavanagh. Adrian Lamb. Dennis Mullen. Stephen Mullen. Patrick Murray. James Norris. James Nyhan. Leo Riley. Con Sheridan. Michael Toomey. Bachelor of Engineering in Manufacturing Technology, Niall Broderick. Brian McMahon. Justin O'Brien Condon. Alan Ryan. Jozo Tat. Bachelor of Engineering in Electrical Technology, Patrick Last. Master of Engineering, Alan Harrington. Thank you, President, and congratulations to all our graduates.
I now call on the President of the Technological University of the Shannon Midlands Midwest, Professor Vincent Canaan, to present the parchments to graduates of the Department of Mechanical and Automobile Engineering, and I request the head of the department, Dr. Philip Ryan, to announce the graduates.
Good afternoon, everybody. President, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed courses in the Faculty of Engineering and the Built Environment Department of Mechanical and Automobile Engineering and are worthy of their award. I request you to present their parchments to them. So the first course is the Bachelor of Engineering in Agricultural Engineering, Shane Hines. Joe Kiernan. And Mark Nolan. The Bachelor of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering, Jack Carrig. Fating Chai. Martin Donnellan. Jack Hayes. Marina Carhina. Salim Awish. Joseph O'Connor. Jack Shanahan. Marcin Blashut. Michael Burke. Paul Burke. Ethan Bracken. Cruster Tiago Concaves Caldas. Navina Kirkovich. Peter Cusack. Jack Downey. Dion de Tut. Rory Gallagher. Kieran Cluckian. David Hinnessy. Jack Hetherington. Liam Hughes. George Keeley. Owen Kemp. Bartosz Kielak. Kieran Londrigan. Kirsten Legut. Michael Lynch. Anthony McKenzie. Adam Merriman. Derry Ormond. Michael Relan. Rhys Reynolds. Aaron Ryan. Mark Walsh. We have a Bachelor of Engineering and Precision Engineering graduate, Owen O'Neill. And we have graduates in the Bachelor of Engineering in Road Transport Technology and Management, Rachel Cahill. Shane Whelan. The Bachelor of Engineering Honours in Process Engineering Management, Eamon Ambrose. Michael Ambrose. Jared Basquiel. Kleena Bowen. James Carey. Aaron Cosgrove. Enda Kniff. Paul Dyson. Charles Henry. Owen Hogan. Joshua Hunt. John Kilcoyne. Dennis Coravin. Paul Lanigan. Darius Markievicz. Jonathan Martin. Michael McDonough. Robert McMahon. Darren McNamara. Dennis Murphy. Emmeth O'Brien. Connie O'Connor. Michael O'Connor. David O'Sullivan. Dean Redican. Simon Reynolds. Darren Roach. Sean Sheehan. Louis Slevin. William Whittle. Just to present awards in the Postgraduate Diploma in Science in Process Validation and Regulatory Affairs. Ayesha Akmal. Tanya Byrne Pratt. Leona Carol Crowley. Nawunka Chukwuma. Thomas Clark. Jade Dalton. Ahmed Kabir. Anthony O'Looney. Kate O'Reilly. Ivan Rusev. Inamira Vasileva. We now come to the Masters in Process Validation and Regulatory Affairs. Igaris Baskovas. Paul Dooley. Claire Ann Ferry. Jared Foley. Dermot Hayes. Rebecca Markey. Agnes Morvai. Emma Reed Lynch. And Bobby Smith. The Bachelor of Science in Aircraft Maintenance Engineering, Anura Andara. Mohammed Mehmood Asraf. Mosaliu Bashua. John Byrne. James Carson. Adipa Muda Vaseri. Edwin Dobby Nosua Osoka. Welcome. Sean O'Brien. Joe Trainer. Just the head of Department of Mechanical and Automobile Engineering would like to thank the president and congratulate the graduates of the conferring ceremony. Thank you.
I now call on the President of the Technological University of the Shannon Midlands Midwest, Professor Vincent Canan, to present the parchments to the graduates of the Department of the Built Environment and request the Head of Department of the Built Environment, Dr. Pat Gill, to announce the graduates.
President, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed courses in the Faculty of Engineering and the Built Environment, Department of the Built Environment, and are worthy of their award. I request you to present their parchments to them. Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering, Farouk Dolapu Ajugran. Patrick Berkery. Sean Handley. Garode McMahon. John Kelly. Connor Melidi. Jack Milan. Bachelor of Arts in Interior Design, Barbara Houlihan. Bachelor of Science, Honours in Construction Management, PJ Allen. Ryan Daniels. James Hodgkinson. Anthony Kennedy. Evan Canaan. Aloch Kotska. Xiaoqing Lee. Vincent Lillis. Colin Nash. Kian O'Mara. Jonathan O'Neill. Owen Power. Shane Rabbit. Michael Stritch. Bachelor of Science, Honours in Civil Engineering Management, Mark Breheny. Loredana Danila. Brian Frawley. Ahmed Hamad. Evan Hannan. Anthony Keane. Jake Kinsella. Philip Kinsella. Jansen Madriaga. Jack Nevin. Sarah O'Gorman. Owen O'Leary. Jude Pendejito. Killian Pickford. Jason Reedy. Bachelor of Science, Honours in Property Valuation Management. Patrick Clancy. Owen Cleary. Ian Cooney. Mark Edwards. Rory Hartigan. Philip Harty. Roisin Lennon. Phoenix Mulcair Shire. Jeremy O'Mahony. Daniel Phelan. Eamon Ryan. Shimon Sloviak. Mark Walsh. Bachelor of Science, Honours in Quantity Surveying. Meg Brennan. Cahill Brosnan. David Brosnan. Vincent Brown. Derek Byrne. Donica Byrne. Emmett Costigan. James Daly. Evan Devitt. Magella Donlan. Daniel Feezy. Teaser Han Fu. Lee Gregg. Adam Heffernan. Evan Kelly. Adam Kennedy. Yokshan Lim. Joseph Lonergan. Fiona Lynch. Barry Mahoney. Tomás McCarthy. Matthew McEntee. Shauna Noonan. Megan O'Brien. Dara O'Connell. Liam O'Sullivan. Jacqueline Ring. Master of Science in Quantity Surveying. Syed Abu Kakar Siddiq Adrianga Samiula. Ankita Grace Andley. Obina Ebuka Anocheli. Libita Baby. Owen Birmingham. Gavin Cahill. Themba Archibald Chibanda. Nikhil Balu Gangwarde. Kevin Hartigan. Chinedu Tokukuwu Ikeme. Sanket Jadhav. Sai Priya Yagumahanti. Ajit Kumar Kakanat Radhakrishnan. Raymond Laffin. Arjun Maragundi Satish. Gerard Moore. John O'Reilly. Thomas Relihan, in absentia. Frank Ronan. Merlin Rose. Gaurish Sriram Sangalkar. Shanto Saji. Connor Sheehy. Fabio Silva Martins. Lokendra Singh. Abin Thomas Varghese. Bachelor of Science in Construction, Health and Safety. Rona Bradish. Greville Carey. Michael Cody. Gwendolyn Gohan. Louise Healy. Robert Herbert, in absentia. Noel Higgins. Elizabeth Keane. Padraig Keegan. Christor McCormack. Christine O'Gorman. Daisha Ogaduri, the Thirk area. Gurumila Mahagat.
I now call on the President to deliver his conferring address.
Aye, just when you thought it was all over and it was safe to go out. Another 45 minutes, I'll be done. Don't worry. So what do you think of the place? What do you know? Not bad. I'll start. I called you. To as and don't arm vein shah on you. August by white love a kid made a falcha curve of galair. Friends, I'd like to extend a warm welcome to the conferring ceremony of the class of 2022. To you, the graduates, to your parents, guardians, relations, partners, and friends. There's also, of course, an audience watching remotely around Ireland and indeed around the world. And I'd also like to give you a very special welcome. The conferring of academic awards is the highlight of the academic calendar, and it's a very special occasion for our community. But as our chair said earlier, you, the class of 2022, have had a remarkable journey to this day. And you will hold, and will hold forevermore, a very special place in the unfolding story of the Technological University of the Shannon. You did indeed meet a unique set of challenges to get here today. The college life they had just grown accustomed to changed fundamentally in March of 2020. But you stuck with it. You persevered. And in so doing, you displayed a willingness to do things differently, to broaden your horizons, and yes, to innovate. You became pioneers in a pioneering university. You succeeded in adversity by adapting to change. And I'm going to reflect for a moment on what that might mean for you and indeed for the wider society we all live in. Remember that your university was born against the backdrop of that pandemic, just as your qualification was earned against that same backdrop. At the same time as you were moving your studies online in 2020, so too the foundational work of this university that we now call TUS moved online. Its foundation was an act of perseverance and a statement of innovation. We emerged as a new institution, using new technologies to reach out to the world, whilst building on a deeply held ethic of inclusiveness and a heritage of education going back generations. And just over a year ago, in the largest higher education event in the world that day, we launched TUS, with well over 3,500 people joining our live stream and over 400 people attending in Athlone and here in Moylish. Your university was thus born of change, and in the future will grow through embracing such change. Because this is a reflection of our world, a world where the ability to drive change and to adapt to change will be defining characteristics in our society. It will be challenging, but it can be also very powerful. And you, the graduates, you all now have an internationally recognised qualification that, as I said, you earned in unprecedented circumstances. And in so doing, you have displayed the ability to adapt to extraordinary change in order to achieve your goals. And you know this yourself, you know it intuitively, you have done it. And this is powerful. And in a way, it's your sort of small superpower. Because you've seen more change over the course of your studies than students had seen for generations previously. And today, you graduate with your qualification very well deserved. But before you can fully realise your new powers, you need to reflect on what you may have lost during this time as well. Since whilst you have grown certain skills, we have all of us, in some way lost something of our relationship with the wider society as a whole. The skills of interaction and the experience of the social mores that were denied to you for so long must be developed again and redeveloped to match the incredible strength that you have shown to get here. You must not become an avatar of yourself. You must re-engage with society, physically and emotionally. The nature of the experience that you went through, the fact that you had to face separation from others, and that you had to retreat from communal life, must be acknowledged. But it should not lead any of you to conclude that whilst you may have been isolated, you were never alone. And these days there is a tendency towards the cult of personality. And I do sincerely hope that that will not be heightened even further in our emerging post-pandemic era. Because communities are even more important for us all now. And you are part of a community. Indeed, you're part of a number of communities. Evolving communities, changing communities, older communities, and the onus on you as our graduates is to create new communities. The great writer Kurt Vonnegut, when addressing a graduate in class like you, asked that they work on, and I quote, building or strengthening your communities. Please love that destiny if it turns out to be yours. For communities are all that substantial about the world. And he lived through the last war in Europe, and he saw a huge change come about through crisis. So he knew what he was talking about, and his views resonate again today. And this is how you must pick up that cudgel to exercise your newfound powers and make them available for wider societal good. Now, TUS, this is now your alma mater, is also focused on building and strengthening our communities. But not just for now, but into the future. Unclear as that future may sometimes seem. And talking now about our own technological universities, our technological universities are not just new universities. We are new kinds of universities that combine international scale and local and regional impact. We represent the advancement of a long-standing and successful concept, though, of higher education, combining practical learning and research that will impact on our world to create a virtuous cycle for individuals, families, communities, society, and the wider economy. As such, the technological universities are of themselves an innovation, and one that will potentially allow society to get ahead of future challenges rather than just responding after those things happen. But like all innovations, we represent change and with it, its inherent risk. We represent the need for our higher education system in which we operate overall to look deeply at what it does, the way that it does it, and to adapt itself so that society can reap the huge potential that the technological universities represent here in Ireland. And with all we face, this is not a time for risk aversion, but rather for risk taking. And if we look at the higher education system in Ireland, it probably has about 250,000 people in it at any given time. But a system of that size can have a tendency to resist change, to absorb the perturbation of change rather than adapt to it. And this must change. The system must change because it is easier to innovate now than to respond later. But today, you, the graduates, you are the most important people in that system. You have led the way, and rest assured that your university will lead the way, and the system will follow. So in reflecting on our journey with us, I recognize the challenges you have faced, and I am inspired by your ability to overcome them. You embody the inescapable fact that change is inherent in life. And, unfortunately, it may well be a constant in your life. But if you embrace it and continue to live through it, then you and society will be the better for that. You are now graduates of the Technological University of the Shannon and part of the Tuus community. And rest assured, we will contribute to that society and we will strengthen our wider economy. And folks, this is the community that you are in for the rest of your lives. There's no escaping the Tuus community. But as I mentioned earlier, you did not make it to this monumentous occasion on your own. And now I'd like to thank those who supported you along the way and offer my heartiest congratulations to you as well. Because you too are part of our community, and today is a major milestone for you. And now, graduates, in recognition of all that they have done for you, maybe you might stand up, turn towards your family and friends, partners, and maybe give them a round of applause and thank them for what they've done for you. That's one of the better claps we got, But as we used to say here, that and your first paycheck will go a long way to helping ease things. To the staff of the institution who have helped to bring you to this day, I also extend my deep thanks and appreciation. You too adapted to change. You continue to adapt to change. But ultimately, you overcame huge challenges to bring our graduates here today. And I want to congratulate you all, and I look forward to continue working with you on our own transformation journey. So thank you very much indeed. Finally, I'm nearly there. To our graduates, I'm sure that I speak for all my colleagues when I say that we have enjoyed your company, both virtual and physical, in this community while you were a student. We will continue to watch your journey with great interest and pride. Let me encourage you to stay in touch with each other and with us in the years to come. I congratulate you again on your successful studies, and I wish you all the best for your future, both professionally and personally. We hope that you will return to visit and fondly remember the time you spent with us. Go Hardes or Cree? I like it though. I like the sentiment. Go Hardes or Cree, Liv. Go Lair. Congratulations from the heart to you all. And I hope that despite everything, you've had the time of your lives. Go Lair.
Our final award today is a special award for the Student of the Year in the Faculty of Engineering and the Built Environment. I call on the Chairperson and the President to present this award. The Student of the Year goes to Ross McNamara. We come now to the end of today's conferring ceremony. I wish to take this opportunity to thank the Assistant Registrar, Dr. Card Lynn, and all the staff associated with the planning and organising of this ceremony. We'd also like to invite our graduates and our guests to join us afterwards in the Scholars Restaurant for refreshments. I now declare this conferring ceremony closed. Please stand for the academic procession, and this time we invite the graduates to join the procession.